reason I hold on. The broken one, but I'm the only one who needed saving. Cause when you never see the light, it's hard to know which one of us is caving. Not really sure how to feel about it. Something in the way you move makes me feel like I can't live without you.
Your door tonight if you need help, if you need help. I'll shut down the city lights, I'll lie, cheat, I'll beg and bribe to make you well, to make you well. When enemies are at your door, I'll carry you away from more if you need help, if you need help. Your hope dangling by a string, I'll share in your suffering to make you well, to make you well. Give me reasons to believe that you would do the same for me, and I would do it for you. You're gone, gone, gone. When you fall like a statue, I'm gonna be there to catch you, put you on your feet, you on your feet. And if your well is empty, not a thing will prevent me. Tell me what you need, what do you need? I surrender honestly. You've always done the same for me, so I will do it for you. You're gone, gone, gone. You're my backbone, you're my cornerstone. You're my crutch when my legs stop moving. You're my head start, you're my rugged heart. You're the pulse that I've always needed. Like a drum, baby, don't stop beating. Like a drum, baby, don't stop beating. Like a drum, baby, don't stop beating. Drum, my heart never stops beating for you.
Good evening, everybody. Let's begin. So good evening and welcome to the 11th Annual Cardinal M Club Student Athlete Awards Ceremony and the SMU Sports Hall of Fame Inductions. I would like you to ask at this time if you'd please join me in welcoming Brother Larry Humphrey, St. Mary's University Director of Mission, to give the invocation.
Thank you and good evening. As we begin our prayer, I invite you at this time also to call to mind whatever needs and intentions you'd like to add to our prayer. Certainly these days we're praying for peace in our world, but also I ask you to remember in your prayers this evening, Mike Herrick, the uncle of Nikki Fennern and Jamie Herrick, who passed away today. So we remember him in our prayers and send our sympathy to his family. So let us remember that we are in the holy presence of God. Good and gracious God, we acknowledge your great love for us and your presence in our lives and in the life of St. Mary's University. Tonight, in a special way, we acknowledge your action in the life of St. Mary's athletics, past, present, and future, and most especially in the life of Redmen and Cardinal athletes for over 100 years. Through athletics, St. Mary's students have learned important lessons about life and sacrifice and spirit and good sportsmanship. These lessons continue today at St. Mary's. We praise you for achievements past, celebrated tonight in the lives of three alumni being inducted into our Sports Hall of Fame. We acknowledge your blessings present as we celebrate the successes of our postseason award winners, outstanding male and female athletes, and our scholar athletes. Our faith in your constant love assures us of your care for our students of today and our Cardinal athletes present here tonight, and for those men and women who will follow them into this, our second century. We praise you for all who in any way support St. Mary's athletics, especially players, coaches, parents, and fans. May the glory be yours, Lord, as we acknowledge with grateful hearts your hand in all that we celebrate tonight. Bless all gathered here this evening and St. Mary's University. St. John Baptist de La Salle, pray for us. Live Jesus in our hearts forever.
Thank you, Brother Larry. This is just such an exciting time to be a part of St. Mary's University and Cardinal Athletics. We are coming off an amazing centennial celebration. I think I can safely say that we not merely launched into our second century, but we've catapulted ourselves into a very successful future 100 years. So within this excitement, athletics and student athletes play a major role, publicly and behind the scenes. So this last year, we cheered as our women's basketball teams, men's tennis, softball, and baseball all represented St. Mary's in conference tournaments. And who can forget the amazing playoff atmosphere for the women's basketball exciting home playoff game. Success is evident across the playing fields. Not since 2005-06 academic year have Cardinal student athletes won this many athletic awards. And the success does not stop with our student athletes, however, as two of our coaches were honored by their peers, being named MIAC Coach of the Year. We absolutely showed our tremendous community spirit as nearly 500 people gathered for the Strong is the New Beautiful 5K in support of Sabrina Bushlack after her car accident. And then behind the scenes, St. Mary's student athletes dedicated approximately 3,500 hours of their precious time to community service projects, And these efforts did not go unnoticed as the student athletes received their third National Community Service Award in the last 5 years. The excitement from last year has definitely continued this year. Today, we unveiled a new scoreboard for the Max Mohlach baseball field. This is the first phase of improvements to our outdoor facilities. And finally, there is still a buzzing on campus about the Stanley Cup at SMU. What a great day. We welcomed the president and CEO of the Chicago Blackhawks, a 1975 alumnus, John McDonough, to campus. As a community, we celebrated Mr. McDonough's second Stanley Cup, and we're honored that he shared that championship spirit with the St. Mary's community. The Winona community absolutely took notice as well, because over 1,000 people came through the Gostomski Fieldhouse to be a part of the excitement. As you can see, we truly are coming off of an exciting year in 2012-13. We have launched ourselves into our second century as a university and as an athletic department. I could not be more proud to be associated with such an amazing institution. Just as important, I have an immense amount of cardinal pride in you, our student athletes and alumni. You will see tonight that we have a lot of reason for celebration, and most importantly, a lot of people to celebrate. And one of the persons who's been a key figure in that boosting of Cardinal athletics and has given the athletic department the support necessary for our enhanced success is our next speaker. And it is my distinct pleasure to introduce our leader, the 13th president of St. Mary's University, Brother William Mann.
So welcome to each and to all of you. It's nice saying hello to the award winners a few minutes ago. It's nice seeing some of the recent alums back, meeting some parents and family members for the first time, and welcoming back some others who have become friends over these 5+ years. Brother Larry had a little trouble with your prayer. When you did particular thanks, because I would like also to keep in our prayers the benefactors of St. Mary's athletic programs, that in this year of coming out of the centennial, we've already begun to have some serious discussions with people who care about you deeply and love this school deeply and are willing then to commit their talent and their time and their resources to the university. The athletic director talks about putting up some signage. Well, that's possible because people believe enough in us that they help us do that. I've been on the road a lot the last 2 weeks. And while it has been a bit exhausting, there was a $945,000 gift and a $100,000 gift. And I'm sincerely hoping that that's not the end of the gifts that come from people who connect and reconnect and believe in this university. Because there are lots of places that each of us could be. There are lots of schools. There are lots of schools in which people can believe and to which they can contribute. And what I say to you is that I think I can say for myself, I know I can also say for a number of the coaches and the people with whom you work every day, that we can't imagine being anywhere else but here with you. Do we have other options? But this is the place that we choose to call home because of the relationships that we have with you, because of the promise that we see in you, because of the accomplishments that we have been humbled to watch, and in some small way, we believe, contribute and participate. And so that while I do pray for families and parents and student athletes and coaches, I'm also praying for good benefactors, because good benefactors are going to help us go the next step. With somebody before saying, some nice LED lights would be nice. The opening of school, I was with the new students and their families and was saying, some nice air conditioning would happen, would be welcome. But you know, you can have lots of things and really not have what really matters. And I think we have a lot of things. But most importantly, we have each other. And we have this chance, which we celebrate tonight, to be a university student in a Division III NCAA school, in one of the finest athletic conferences in the nation, which is at times a challenge. But it is the challenge that calls forth in individuals and in teams a greatness. The thing about a Division III school, of a Division III NCAA school, of a MIAC school, is that what we're celebrating tonight, yes, athletic achievement and success, but academic rigor, academic quality, that combination is why in the mission of MIAC, our conference, we talk about the important contribution that competitive athletics can make in the quality of an education, which is primarily grounded in the academics. So you're not asked to sacrifice the very thing for which you come to college, but you're asked to engage and to embrace and to dig in at the same time that you get to do something that you love dearly. And I can see that. Even again this fall, wandering through the gym, finding the volleyball players, or out across as I'm heading over towards Brother Leopold and the Residencia, and we're catching the soccer folks out there. Or last Saturday, being with some of you as you ran cross country. And I can continue the examples where I see the joy and the passion and the excitement that you have. And the promise of our school and of the division schools, Division III schools, that you're going to get good academics and that we're committed to student athlete well-being and integrity and competitive quality athletics. Now, I spent the last few days with someone who sits on the national board of NCAA. I also spent time with the executive director of MIAC, our conference. I also spent yesterday morning with business leaders in the Twin Cities. And what we were talking about were those, we called them soft qualities, that you get at the same time that you're playing sports and you're studying and you're advancing towards your degree. And one of the leaders of the Fortune 500 companies in the Twin Cities said, I want new employees who come out and they know how to belong to a team. They're committed to the good of the whole. They don't give up. They've got the guts to dig in and stay for the whole game. I want people who know discipline. Another one said, I want people who come to work on time and who know how to dress when they show up. So many of the things that you're learning on the courts and the playing fields and the pass through the bluffs and on the ice, and so many things that you're learning in laboratories and classrooms and in other student activities, are the very things that are going to single you out when you sit for a job interview or for a promotion. And I'm very sincere in saying that, because I see your goodness. I see your goodness. I applaud your goodness. I'm proud to partner with the coaches that we have here at St. Mary's, because they are deeply committed in you being successful in your academics and competitive and successful in athletics, but also that you're going to be a good human being of integrity, that you're going to acquire the skills and the gifts that you need to help make the home in which you live, the neighborhood of which you are a part, and that place in which you work be the kind of place that we believe St. Mary's is, a special place, a place where we care for one another, we self-sacrifice, we chip in, we play fair, but we play tough. And so congratulations to the awardees. It's good to have you back home at St. Mary's. Congratulations to others who will win tonight, but truly and sincerely, congratulations to all of the student athletes who've had the courage and the determination to come out for an NCAA sport, to put yourself on the line, to step forward, to say, I'd like to do this. I think I have something to offer. I think this will make a difference for me. I congratulate you on that choice, and I congratulate you on the choice you make every day when you give your best in your sports and in your classrooms. So welcome again tonight, and again, congratulations.
Thank you, Brother William. This is the time where we get to really lift up those student athletes who have put so much on the line and dedicated so much to their time, to their sport, and to their academic success. So we'll give out this evening will be dedicated to honoring our Student Athlete Award winners. And here to give our awards for our Student Athlete Award winners are going to be Chris Kendall and Mike Lester, if you could come to stage, please. Chris is a 1979 alumnus and the current Vice President for Student Life. Formerly, Chris was the Director of Athletics, Dean of Students, Assistant Baseball and Men's Basketball Coach, and a Baseball Student Athlete. Chris is also a 2012 inductee into the SMU Sports Hall of Fame. Mike Lester is the Head Volleyball Coach for the Cardinals and also serves as the Assistant Director of Athletics. Coach Lester has twice led the Cardinal volleyball teams to the NCAA tournament and has more wins than any other coach in the history of SMU volleyball. Please welcome Chris and Mike to stage. Our first group of honorees are our Academic All-Conference recipients. In order to be named Academic All-Conference, a student athlete must be a sophomore, junior, or senior and have a minimum cumulative GPA of a 3.5 on a 4.0 scale. They must also meet competitive requirements specific to his or her MIAC sport. As you're called to stage, I ask you to please approach the stage over here on my left and receive your award from Chris, and then we'll remain on stage until all the award winners are present. We're going to start with our fall academic all-conference recipients. First, from women's soccer, Heidi Martin. Melissa Rademacher. Melissa was not able to be with us this evening. And Bethany Schmidt from Women's Soccer. From volleyball, Kaylee Bunny. And also Molly Grover. From men's cross country, Peter Borash. Aaron Haley. John Souchere. Gabe Thiel. And Jake Traxler. From our women's cross country team, Elizabeth Scott, Amy Spitzmuller, Katie Stoles, and Kristen Thielen. Congratulations to our Fall Sport and Academic All-Conference student athletes. Next, we'll do our winter sport Academic All-Conference, and I think we'll hold our applause until we have all of our athletes on stage. First of all, from men's hockey, Michael Walter. From women's hockey, Julianne Bartos. Also Mackenzie Klimick. From women's basketball, Sarah Schoenthaler. From women's swimming and diving, Andrea Fogel. Abby Lowe. Caitlin McClay. And Kristen Wilkes. Congratulations to our Winter Sport Academic All-Conference student athletes. Finally, we will recognize our Spring Sport Academic All-Conference recipients. From softball, Julianne Bartos. Right back. Samantha Borowski. Paige Carter, Haley Ohl, and Kristen Thielen. From the baseball program, Paul Lanassa. From men's track and field, John Souchere. Peter Borash. and Jake Traxler.
This is like deja vu.
From women's track and field, Katie Stoles. From women's tennis, Lindsay Reinich. And Grace Zachman. Congratulations. Tonight, we will also honor baseball student-athlete Kevin Gannon as Capital One Academic All-District. Kevin, will you please come to stage? This prestigious honor is bestowed upon student-athletes who meet strict academic and athletic guidelines and is voted on by NCAA Division III Sports Information Directors. Congratulations, Kevin. Throughout the course of each season, the Minnesota Intercollegiate Athletic Conference recognizes athletes of the week in each sport. St. Mary's University had 7 student athletes named the MIC Athlete of the Week for the 12-13 season. Please come forward to receive your award. Peter Borash, men's cross country. Jamie Steffley, women's basketball. Sarah Jansen, women's swimming and diving. Deanne Weber, women's tennis. And Colin Kozarowski, men's tennis. Congratulations to our athletes of the week. Next is our biggest group of the night. We had 24 student athletes who were named either honorable mention all conference or received a special recognition from the Minnesota Intercollegiate Athletic Conference. We'll recognize them at this point. First, Fernando Camacho, men's soccer. Caroline Blackwood, women's soccer. Peter Borash, men's cross country. Jake Traxler, men's cross country. Austin Belko, men's hockey. Bobby Thompson, men's hockey. Haley Coolsett, women's hockey. Mackenzie Klimek, women's hockey. Brianna Peterson, women's hockey. Mackie Fadness. Mackie was a member of the MIC All-Rookie Team for women's hockey. Courtney Early. Courtney was honorable mention All-Conference for women's basketball and also a member of the MIC All-Defensive Team. Bridget Pethke. Bridget was a member of the MIAC All-Rookie Team for women's basketball. Will Swigum, men's basketball, MIAC All-Rookie Team. Willie Dahl, baseball, MIAC All-Defensive Team. John Soucheray, men's indoor track and field, 5,000 meters. Coco Booker, women's indoor track and field, shot put. Paige Carter, softball. Haley Ohl, softball. Maya Booker, women's outdoor track and field, hammer throw. And I believe they're already up here. Peter Borash for men's outdoor track and field, 1,500 meters. And Jake Traxler, men's outdoor track and field, steeplechase. I think we need a bigger stage. Congratulations. Fifteen of our student athletes were named to the MIAC All-Conference team. We'll announce those who are in attendance this evening. First, from men's soccer, Matt Graber. From volleyball, Lexi Asimos. From men's cross country, Aaron Haley. From women's hockey, Mackie Fadness. From men's basketball, Michael Burfind. From women's basketball, Jamie Steffley. Also from women's basketball, Jess Thone. From softball, Alex Raske. And from baseball, Tyler Kreshak. Congratulations are all conference student athletes. Our next awards are All-Region awards. We had three student athletes earn All-Region honors during the 12-13 academic year, and two are with us this evening. In women's basketball, Jamie Steffley was named to the D3Hoops.com All-West Region third team. Congratulations, Jamie. And in softball, Alex Raske was named to the National Fast Pitch Coaches Association All-Region second team. Congratulations, Alex. Congratulations to both of you on your All-Region selections. In each sport, the NCAA recognizes statistical champions for each major category. At this time, I ask Brianna Peterson from women's hockey to come forward. During the 2012-13 season, Brianna was the best in the nation as she led all Division III women's hockey student athletes in shorthanded goals. Congratulations, Brianna, on this accomplishment. Mm-hmm. I'll also ask at this time if Coach Mandy Pearson and Coach Jeff Hallberg will join us on stage. Behind all of our student athletes are great coaches. They are often the unsung heroes who put in countless hours for the betterment of their teams and individual student athletes. All of our coaches work extremely hard to provide a positive experience for our student athletes on and off the field of competition. In 2012-13, these two coaches were named MIAC Coach of the Year as selected by their coaching peers. Congratulations, Coach Pearson and Coach Hallberg. What a fun opportunity to really lift up all of our student athletes, all of our award winners, and those who are role players for their teams as well. We appreciate all that you do, and we are proud of all of our student athletes and coaches. Thank you for representing Cardinal Athletics and St. Mary's University. Let's congratulate all of our award winners again. And next on the program, I would like to, introduce to you the president of the St. Mary's University Alumni Association Board of Directors, a 1987 graduate of St. Mary's, Joe Hettinger.
Good evening. My name is Joe Hettinger. I am the president of the Alumni Board of Directors and proud member of the class of 1987. On behalf of St. Mary's Alumni Association and its Board of Directors, congratulations to all of our students who are being recognized this evening. We are indeed very proud of your accomplishments. I would also like to extend a special congratulations to our Hall of Fame inductees, Ashley, Todd, and Greg, and their families who are with us this evening. We welcome you back to St. Mary's. It's wonderful to have you all here for the 11th annual M Club Weekend and Hall of Fame Awards Ceremony. Just as you excelled in your respective sports while at St. Mary's, I am certain you are also excelling in all aspects of your current lives. St. Mary's has a proud heritage of preparing its students to leave this university as alumni that are well prepared to succeed in their workplaces, their community, and the world. Just last week, as was mentioned, the university recognized such an alum with John McDonough, class of 75, and president and CEO of the Chicago Blackhawks, who did return here to campus to share his success with the Stanley Cup. That was a great day to show our Cardinal pride, as every day is a great day to show our Cardinal pride. So this evening, we celebrate not only the honorees and their accomplishments as student athletes, and leaders, but also the many triumphs that are waiting you on horizons. I want to congratulate all of you. I want to wish you a good evening and a great weekend in Winona. Thank you.
So one of the most anticipated parts of this night is the induction of new members into the SMU Sports Hall of Fame. The Sports Hall of Fame recognizes those individuals who have coached or performed as varsity athletes and for the university and have brought honor to themselves and St. Mary's. I ask Brother William to please return to stage as he will present the plaques to the Hall of Fame inductees. And also at this time, it is my pleasure to reintroduce the head volleyball coach and assistant director of athletics for the Cardinals, Mike Lester, to induct Ashley Dingles-Gossin into the SMU Sports Hall of Fame. Please help me welcome both Brother William and Mike.
Thanks, Nikki. Thank you all. I couldn't be more proud to be standing in front of you all tonight to help induct into the SMU Sports Hall of Fame one of its newest members. Ashley Gossin from the class of 2005 was, and as members of the SMU volleyball team will find out during the alumni game tomorrow, still is a remarkable athlete. I'm so thrilled to get the chance to talk about her today. I am tremendously proud of the fact that since Ashley's graduation, she and her family have remained committed to this university. Ashley's husband, Tim, is currently the Dean of Students here on campus, and Ashley, despite being employed full-time and being the mother of three young children, dedicates her time each week to serve as an assistant coach with the current volleyball team. As I begin, I want to take a moment to thank St. Olaf College Volleyball for not recruiting Ashley. Most don't know that Ashley's older brother, Corey, was an outstanding student athlete for the Olies. He still holds a long jump record there, as well as being a multiple-time All-American. Thankfully, Ashley chose to go her own path and come to SMU. I also want to thank former St. Mary's track and field coach, Paul Thornton, for recruiting Ashley and bringing her to our attention in the volleyball program. Ashley attended St. Mary's and was a student during a decade of tremendous success in SMU athletics, particularly on the women's side. In the early and mid-2000s, SMU had multiple appearances in the women's basketball playoffs, the women's tennis playoffs, as well as playing the women's hockey team playing in two national tournaments. We won the MIAC title in volleyball and appeared in the NCAA volleyball championships twice, not to mention a women's softball fourth place national finish and a national championship in softball. Through this period of success in SMU women's athletics, Ashley stood out as one of the all-time great SMU athletes. As noted in Ashley's biography, she was a two-time first-team All-MIAC volleyball player, as well as a seven-time MIAC champion in track and field, a five-time national qualifier, and two-time All-American, once in the heptathlon and once in the high jump. Ashley still holds the MIAC record in the heptathlon. Perhaps the most telling thing about all of these accomplishments for Ashley, and what helps to define her as a competitor and tireless worker, is that she was selected first team all-conference in volleyball and named an All-American in the high jump the year after tearing her ACL in a volleyball match. One of Ashley's teammates, Tessa Wagnold, may have said it best, and I'm quoting Tessa here. "I am so happy for Ashley. I wish I could be there for her this weekend. From the day her athletic career at St. Mary's ended, we knew it would only be a matter of time before she received this honor." Ashley, I couldn't have put it better than Tessa did. So congratulations and welcome to the St. Mary's University Sports Hall of Fame, class of 2013.
I would like to start off tonight by thanking a few individuals. Throughout my time here at St. Mary's, I had 12 different coaches for volleyball and track, but the two most influential to me are still here coaching and great assets to St. Mary Athletics. Coach Ward Burnt was my high jump coach for my senior year. I always appreciated the time he put in with me on individual sessions. He helped me to become a more consistent high jumper than I had been over the previous 3 years, and I really wish I had had another season to work with him. Ward was great at coaching me as an individual. He found my strengths to determine the technique and approach I would use to be able to jump higher. Coach Mike Lester was the head volleyball coach for all four of my years. I still remember going into his office after the end of preseason my first year. At that time, there was both a varsity and JV team, and nobody got cut. There were three other freshman middle hitters vying for one opening on the varsity team. He asked me how I thought preseason went and where I thought my role on the team should be. I remember I told him I was hoping I could be starting for the JV. He just nodded and then kind of said, "Well, I think you should start for the varsity." So I'm just glad he could see the potential in me that I definitely could not see at that time. I thank both Ward and Mike for all the time they spent coaching me and developing me into a better athlete and person, and for the time and effort they continue to give to St. Mary's Athletics. Lastly, I would like to thank my parents and family for all the support they gave me during my career. I learned from them from early on the value of hard work, and it is that value that made me into the athlete that I was. As a captain for volleyball and track, I was never going to be the person to give the rah-rah, pump-you-up speech in the huddle. But instead, I tried to lead by example, by always working hard and pushing myself and others to improve. I appreciate that they could be with me here tonight as I receive this honor. Reflecting on my time as an athlete here, the thing I miss most about being involved in college athletics is a competitive atmosphere. I love going to the gym or track every day with the goal of making myself and the team better and being surrounded by others with the same goal. It is an atmosphere I haven't been able to repeat since, both in the athletic arena or in the business world. Some of my most memorable track moments were practices that seemed impossible at the time, like doing 400 repeats until we could no longer make our time. I definitely did more than I thought I would when we started the practice because of the teammates who pushed me to go further. Afterwards, despite being dead tired, I knew I had a great practice. Another memory was running a relay with teammates and having our coach run down after we finished the race, only to show us our school record-setting time on his stopwatch. I will never forget those memories of doing things I didn't think I could do. I have continued to play volleyball in different levels, but no matter what level it is, with fun with the family or in competitive with other post-college athletes, it never feels the same. The wins and losses just don't mean as much. I have been fortunate to be able to help out with the volleyball team here at St. Mary's for the last 6 years. I also try to always go to the home indoor and outdoor track and field meets. I love being able to watch the players grow and mature athletically, and it's also my way of still getting to be a part of that competitive atmosphere. I need to thank Mike for having me be a part of the volleyball team and also my husband and children, as this takes a lot of time away from them and I would not be able to do it without their support. Lastly, I would just like to congratulate Todd and Greg on their inductions and the other athletes receiving awards here tonight. You have put a lot of time and hard work into your sport, and you're now being honored for your efforts. So congratulations to all of you. I wish everyone here the best of luck for your seasons this year. I hope you all enjoy your time as an athlete and take away as much from your experiences as you possibly can. Thank you.
Thank you, Ashley, and congratulations. Our next inductor is Kevin Murphy from the class of 1985. Kevin was a key contributor to both the men's hockey and baseball teams during his time at St. Mary's University. Kevin continues to be a major supporter of Cardinal Athletics, and we are glad to have him return to campus to induct Todd Borndale into the SMU Sports Hall of Fame. Kevin?
When you turn this age, you got to put glasses on, so pardon my... Good evening, everyone. I'd like to first congratulate Ashley and Greg on this tremendous honor. I was fortunate to play with Greg during his days here at St. Mary's, and I can say that there was not a more talented hockey player in the MIAC during his tenure, so Dickers, congratulations. Tonight is a real honor for me as I get to introduce a guy that I was fortunate to play baseball with during our time here at St. Mary's, a guy that I have known for over 30 years. Borny, we're getting old. As well as one of my best friends. I also want to thank Billy Moore because when the phone rang at my house and I saw it was coming from St. Mary's, the first thing that went through my head was, had they performed an audit on my academic performance here, and there was a recall of my transcript. So I was really pleased to get that phone call, Billy, so thank you. Todd was born the third of four boys. Mrs. Borndale, you're a saint. He grew up on the east side of St. Paul, attended Presentation Grade School, and Hill Murray High School, where he accomplished many team and individual goals. Upon graduation from Hill Murray, he enrolled at St. Mary's. Todd's statistics are a testament to the talent he was blessed with and the determination he strove for during his days at St. Mary's. Todd played in 125 of 126 possible games. He had a .338 career batting average. In 1985, he had a year that was unforgettable. He hit .408 with 14 home runs, which is a school record. He had a .990 slugging percentage with 97 total bases. During this campaign, he earned both All-MIAC, All-Midwest Region. He finished his career at St. Mary's College ranked number one in home runs. This on a field that was 375 feet down the lines, which was further than any Major League Baseball field at that time, if you can imagine that. He finished second in walks and among the top 10 in slugging percentage and total bases and on-base percentage. One last record that Borney holds is the number of days wearing a neck dickie. For those of you who play sports in the spring here, you're familiar with the neck dickie. When we were freshmen here at St. Mary's, Max Moloch gave each of us a neck dickie as a freshman. And he said, whenever it's cold, wear this neck dickie. I can tell you that Borney wore his neck dickie whether it was 100 degrees out or it was 20 degrees out. So Borney, I have a little present for you. Finally, it's my honor and privilege to introduce a man that I love like a brother. Please welcome Todd Borndale, class of 85.
Thanks, Murph. First I want to do is I want to congratulate Ashley and Dickers for their induction in the Hall of Fame. I don't know you very well, Ashley, but your accomplishments are unbelievable. And Dickers, I've been with Dickers 3 years, and actually my freshman year and Dickers' sophomore year, we live right next to each other over in Benilde. Or was it Ed's? Ed's? Sorry, Dickers. Okay. And you deserve it. Let me tell you, Dickers, we had a lot of fun. What I want to do is I want to thank the Alumni Association, and the Cardinals M Club. And with the Cardinal M Club, I really want to thank Billy Moore. Billy, I want to thank you for everything you've done for me and my family this week. I really appreciate it. It's been a great night so far. I can't wait till tomorrow. I also want to thank my mom and dad for everything they've done. People thank their parents for driving to ball games, driving to practice, stuff like that. But I got three brothers. And so we got all four of us, and all four of us played baseball, football, and hockey. So for about 15 years of my mom and dad's life, that's all they did. It was all about us, and they, you know, they went to everything we could. I swear that they saw every baseball diamond, hockey rink, and football field in Minnesota. I really believe they did. I want to thank my wife Mary. This February we'll be married for 25 years. And if anybody knew me in college, there's no way anybody would put up with me for 25 years. I want to thank my three kids, my daughter Devin, my daughter Stephanie, and my son Nathan. I'm so proud of everything you guys did, and I'm just looking so much for the future and see what it holds for you guys, because I know I'm going to be just as proud. And I want to thank my four coaches. My first coach, Max Moloch, who I was fortunate enough to play, Kevin and I played for him, and our freshman year, I believe was his 42nd year of coaching at St. Mary's. So he's a little bit older, and I got a couple stories at the very end for you. And I got some later on when my mom and dad are not around. My assistant coach freshman year is Matt Smith. And then my junior year and senior year head coach is George Druchis and Coach Ed Service. I appreciate everything they did for me during those last 2 years. Baseball has always been a very important part of my life. I've had friendships that have lasted back from Babe Ruth baseball through high school and now through college. And Murph's a great example. I spent a lot of time at Murph. He's over in Arizona. And I try to spend a week in February over there just to visit him. He's a great, great friend. When I was growing up over in St. Paul, I was fortunate enough to have played on some pretty good baseball teams. And I got chances to play in three or four state tournaments through VFW, American Legion, and Babe Ruth baseball. So when I was a junior in high school at Hill Murray, I was trying to decide where I wanted to go to school. And that was the first time I met Max Mollock. And Max came in a couple of my games when I was a junior, and then a handful of my games were a senior. And we were discussing a couple of things, and one of the first things Max said was that St. Mary's is a small school with really good academics, but it's known for baseball. And that's what I really wanted. I didn't want to go to a college and play on a baseball team just to play and not do well in the conference. And I believe our 4 years, we were always in the top half of the MIAC. So I just think that the fit was really good. And after I came down for a visit, I spoke with Max one more time. And that time he told me that my freshman year, the baseball team would be spending 10 days in Hawaii, playing 14 games. In my eyes, that was really a good recruiting tool. I've always thought that through the years, when you think of St. Mary's, you think of baseball. And I like to think for Division III, when you think of baseball, you think of St. Mary's. I know there's a couple times that St. Mary's has been extremely competitive, and we had a couple, I want to say, two or three years where they were kind of in the middle of the pack to the lower of the pack. And I was kind of disappointed because I think that that stretch is not what St. Mary's baseball is about. And I'm really excited now. I was fortunate enough to watch him play a couple games, and the way Coach Nick Winicky's taken the team and the student athletes he has, and rumor has it coming in also this year. I know they were in the playoffs the last couple of years, and I think that he's really got them going in the right direction. And I really want to thank Coach Winicky for getting them back on path and being the top of the conference now. That's what I think is very important for St. Mary's. One quick story about Max. Now, Max was 73 or 74, I'm not even sure. Tony, something like that? Okay, about that. Okay, so he was in his 42nd year of coaching us. And I was here last April and May watching my daughter play softball against St. Mary's. And I was sitting down the third baseline up in the bleachers. And I was watching the game, and then Coach Winicky had his baseball team practicing. And then when they finished up practice, they all met in the infield. And I think Coach was probably talking about their previous game or who they're going to play the next day or what they're going to do. But when they left, when Coach finished talking, they all left. And I had to smile because I was looking over there, and I remember my freshman year, we'd finished up with practice, and we'd all come to the infield, and Coach Mollock would talk to us, but then we'd finish, and we'd had to dump out the buckets of balls because he started with 100 balls. And if we had 98, we weren't allowed to leave until we found the last two. Now, I'm not lying. He bought the balls on his first year at St. Mary's. So the balls were well over 40 years old, too. And every one, the stitches were coming out, and they were waterlogged. And I never understood that until about 3 weeks into my freshman year after the season started. We finished practice. I went through the locker room on my way back to my dorm, and I walked by the laundry room, and Max was dumping a bucket of baseballs in the wash machine. So he would actually wash the balls, then throw them in the dryer, and that's what we had to use. You know, I never understood. I don't understand how Max didn't realize that these balls are shot puts. You know, but that's the way it was. Again, I just want to thank everybody who's involved. It's just been a great night. And I'm truly humbled with this honor tonight. Thank you very much.
Thank you, and congratulations, Todd. and now introduce Bill Moore, our head men's hockey coach and director of the Cardinal M Club, for his induction of Greg Arnes into the SMU Sports Hall of Fame. Coach Moore is a 1985 St. Mary's graduate, and following a stellar career as a boys head high school hockey coach, he returned to his alma mater in 2008 as the head men's hockey coach, and as I said, is the director of the Cardinal M Club. Please help me welcome Bill Moore.
First of all, I'd like to congratulate Ashley Borney Dickers. Congratulations. Ashley, if you'd have gone to school with us, you'd probably have a nickname too. I apologize for not having one for you. Our next Hall of Fame inductee is Greg Arnes. I'm not going to take time to read you his personal and individual accomplishments. You can read those in the program, and they are many, including being MIAC Player of the Year. What I am going to tell you about, many of his teammates don't even know. Greg is a very humble person, probably the most humble person that I've ever met in my life. To give you an idea of how talented Greg was, I'm going to tell you a little bit about a year between his freshman and sophomore year. Greg was invited after his freshman year to what is now called the World Junior Program, World Junior Hockey Program, and was invited to try out in that program. There were 8 goalies in the entire country that were invited. That's Division I and Division III, as well as students who are goaltenders who may not have been a college athlete. So he was one of 8. After his tryout time, they invited him back. He was one of the final 4 to make the U.S. national team. Mind you, again, this is every goaltender in the country. No matter what division, no matter if they played major juniors, no matter if they played junior A, whatever the case may be. Unfortunately, Dickers didn't make the team. 2 of the goaltenders that were selected, one was John Van Beesbroek, who was inducted into the USA Hockey Hall of Fame after playing 882 games over 21 seasons in the NHL. The other was John Casey, who at the time was starting for the University of North Dakota Fighting Sioux and also played 325 games in the NHL, including 8 seasons with the Minnesota North Stars. Not bad competition for a Division III athlete. Dickers gave a great showing of him for himself, for his family, as well as all of St. Mary's College. To cap off an outstanding summer, Greg was drafted by the Winnipeg Jets in the annual NHL draft. In my mind, what really makes Greg special is, despite all of his individual accomplishments and despite all of the accolades that he has received in his life, his character and his integrity are second to none. It would have been very easy for Greg to be arrogant and even a little bit upset with some of our players at the time, but he wasn't. Arrogance wasn't in his vocabulary. He was one of the best teammates that anyone could ever ask for, and in my mind, he's the best teammate that I have ever had. His work ethic and competitiveness were second to none. If you'd have seen him in the goal during practice, guys taking slap shots from the faceoff dots and him coming out at them, and if they shot too high, he'd go out and hit him with a stick or go and poke check him and try and trip him, trying to get him back any way he could. He was always the first on the ice. He was always the last off the ice. If someone wanted to shoot, his attitude was bring it. Over his 4-year career at St. Mary's, Greg faced 3,067 shots for an average of 47 shots per game and led the Redmen to an NAIA national tournament appearance in 1980 and 81. Now, mind you, our goal is 25 shots against to keep the teams at. He was getting 47. All you need to do is look around at the people in attendance today, the people tomorrow at the golf tournament, the people at the receptions, and you'll know how much Greg was loved. He is joined today by his wife, Wendy, and daughters, Marie and Emily. as well as his father Walt, brother Tim, and unbelievable amounts of friends. As a former roommate, there are many other stories that I could tell you, but I'm not gonna. I will just say one thing. Congratulations, buddy. It's my great honor and pleasure to introduce you to the newest member of the St. Mary's University Athletic Hall of Fame, Greg Arns.
Sit with me, Minnesota hockey fans. Let's play hockey! I've always wanted to do that. Hockey was my passion. I loved playing and coaching hockey. But to think that I'd be standing up here tonight in the presence of so many great student athletes, successful alumni, and all my wonderful family and friends is truly humbling, and I'm honored to be here tonight. The tears, because I think there's gonna be some, that's where it all started. When I was 8 years old, our team needed a goalie. My dad had been a goalie, we talked about it, so I said I'd give it a try. That first practice, it was tough. But they were pushing me out there saying, you know what, you're gonna be fine, it's not gonna hurt. And I think mostly they were right, until I got to St. Mary's and I met a guy named Dave Revere. They called him Bombo. Well, to me that meant that he had a bomb. And every time that puck hit me, it exploded and it hurt. Ah, the memories of being a goalie. You're going to have a lot of great memories here at St. Mary's. And to the student athletes out there, cherish every single one of your friends and your memories that you make here at St. Mary's. You're never going to believe 30 years from now what a wonderful, wonderful weekend you may have. It's just amazing to think all the people that I have here tonight for me, and it's just going to be a wonderful weekend. I can't wait for the rest of it. I've got so many people to thank for helping me be here tonight. To my teammate, roommate, and great friend, Bill Moore, thank you for that wonderful introduction. To the M Club and the Alumni Association, thank you for what I know is going to be a great weekend to remember. I also want to congratulate Todd and Ashley on their inductions tonight as well. A huge thank you goes out to my family. A large family, 6 kids. To my mom and dad, you are simply amazing parents. Thank you for coming to every game and dealing with the pressures of being a goalie's parent. Having to listen to the taunts and names like Civ, 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 and Swiss cheese every time a goal was scored. To my dad, who was really my coach, thank you for encouraging me, supporting me, pushing me, financing me, and most of all, giving me the confidence to succeed. Thank you, Dad. Thank you to my brother, Tim. I always looked up to my older brother, Tim, because he was an athlete. He probably doesn't even know this, but I loved watching him and his teammates play hockey. He and his teammates taught me the right way to play the game. Tim, you and your teammates were my heroes. My sisters, Mary, Peggy, Jane, and Carolyn, they cheered me on every step of the way. I enjoyed watching them and their teammates, but not exactly for the same reason as my brother. To my lovely wife, Wendy, and my daughters, Marie and Emily, thank you for giving me a new passion, my family. I'm proud to tell everyone that you are my family. I've had so many great coaches over the years. I grew up in a great neighborhood with hockey tradition. My goal was to play for what, in my mind, was the ultimate Minnesota high school hockey experience, playing for Minneapolis Southwest, Coach Dave Peterson, and playing in the state high school hockey tournament. A story about Coach Peterson. Tryouts my junior year. Coach Peterson said to me one day at practice, "The job is yours to lose, little guy." And he skated away. I don't think they scored another goal that day in practice. I was so excited. I was not going to lose that job. I knew from that moment on that Coach Peterson believed in me. He taught me that hard work and discipline were the keys to success. And I guess that hard work paid off for him. He went on to coach the 1988 and 1992 United States Olympic hockey teams. I'm proud to say that I played for Coach Peterson. At St. Mary's, Don Olson, a Hall of Famer himself, took a chance on a freshman. First game, 2 goals in the first 5 minutes. Right about then, I'm thinking, this is no way to make it to the Hall of Fame. But Coach O, in his ever calm demeanor, stuck with me, and we stormed back and won 5-2. I had another coach who believed in me. Coach O taught us not to panic and to always stay positive. I'm proud to say that I played for Coach Olson and Mike Flynn and Ralph Stevens, who were assistant coaches. To all my great teammates and players who I was so fortunate to coach here at St. Mary's, especially of those who are in attendance here tonight, thank you for being here and making this a truly remarkable night to remember. To my 3 great roommates, Donnie Netto, Bill Moore, Brian Harrison, and their families, thanks for 30 years of great memories. In closing, to the student athletes in the audience, I want to wish you good luck on the playing field and in the classroom this year. To the coaches, continue to push these athletes and inspire them to dream big. Make sure you tell them that you believe in them. Thank you for coming and have a great evening.
Thank you, and congratulations, Greg. And then great congratulations to all of our new Hall of Fame members. Let's give them one more round of applause. So we're at the final 4 awards of our evening, and the first 2 are the 2 that the athletic department recognizes each year, and that's the combination of academic and athletic excellence. And in that, we award a male and a female Scholar Athlete of the Year. The recipient has to be at least a junior and is chosen based on cumulative grade point average, and they're having a significant contribution to their sport. To help us with these awards, I ask that Dr. Donna Aronson, our Vice President for Academic Affairs, come forward to stage. We'll begin with our male Scholar Athlete. And for the 2nd consecutive year, this person is Jake Traxler of the cross country and track and field teams. Jake, will you please come forward? Jake was one of the Cardinals' top cross country runners in the fall, while also proving to be a top-notch steeplechaser during the outdoor track and field season. Jake earned academic all-conference and honorable mention all-conference honors in both cross-country and outdoor track and field. A senior biochemistry major from La Center, Minnesota, Jake graduated from St. Mary's University in 2013 with a near-perfect 3.977 GPA. Congratulations, Jake. Our female Scholar Athlete of the Year is Bethany Schmidt. Bethany, please come forward. Bethany competed in both soccer and swimming and diving in 2012-13 academic year. Bethany was a regular on the soccer pitch for SMU and led the team in points, goals, and assists during the 2012 season. She followed that season by jumping in the pool as a contributor to the swimming and diving team. A junior biology major in 2012-13 from Sparta, Wisconsin, Bethany has maintained an outstanding 3.942 GPA through her first 3 years as a Cardinal, and we certainly look forward to Bethany's senior year in a Cardinal uniform. Congratulations, Bethany. And our final two awards of the evening are the Male and Female Outstanding Student Athletes. These awards are the most prestigious award given to current student athletes in the St. Mary's University Athletic Department. First, I would like to announce the finalists for our Male Outstanding Student Athletes in alphabetical order. And if you would all stand when I call your name, that I would appreciate it. From basketball, Michael Burfind. From cross country and track and field, Peter Borash. Also from cross country and track and field, Aaron Haley. From baseball, Tyler Kreshak. And from tennis, Michael Lunka. Michael was unable to be with us this evening. Our 2012-13 Male Outstanding Athlete is Peter Borash. Peter, will you please come forward? Peter enjoyed a banner senior season as a member of the Cardinal cross country and track and field programs. During the cross country season, Peter was one of the Cardinals' top finishers in each of their six meets, including a first place showing at the SMU No Limit Invitational and an honorable mention All-MIC effort at the conference championships. He picked up right where he left off during the track and field season, earning honorable mention all-conference honors in the 1500, while also breaking the school's 13-year-old record in the 1500 at the UW-Lacrosse Last Chance Meet, the final meet of his collegiate career. A three-time All-MIAC honorable mention selection and a three-time MIAC All-Academic performer, Peter was also named St. Mary's University's 2012-13 Outstanding Male Senior. Congratulations, Peter. And finally, our finalists for the Female Outstanding Student Athlete are the following. Again, please stand as I read your name. From volleyball, Lexi Asimos. From hockey, Brianna Peterson. From softball, Alex Raske. From basketball, Jamie Steffley. And also from basketball, Jess Thone. Sorry, Jess. Our 2012-13 Female Outstanding Athlete is Alex Raske. Alex took the conference by storm as a freshman, a year in which she earned first-team All-MIAC honors. As an encore, she earned a second straight appearance on the All-MIAC first team as a sophomore, as well as a spot on the NFCA All-Central Region second team. Alex finished 2013 among the team leaders in virtually every offensive category, including batting average, at-bats, runs, doubles, home runs, RBIs, total bases, slugging percentage, there's more, walks, and on-base percentage, while helping the Cardinals to their third straight MIAC tournament appearance. Congratulations, Alex. Well, I think we've had a good night, to say the least. We've got to honor numerous current student-athletes, alumni, and our Hall of Fame inductees. What a way to launch into the next century of St. Mary's University and Cardinal Athletics. Alumni, I cannot thank you enough for setting the stage for our current and our future student-athletes. To our current student-athletes, you exemplify Cardinal pride and represent our institution on a daily basis. I am so proud of your accomplishments, and it is my true delight to be associated with our student-athlete alumni and current student-athletes as we work together to continue to build Cardinal Athletics. This does conclude the 11th Annual Cardinal M Club Awards Ceremony, but there's one thing left. They don't like it, but we need to thank a few people. First, I want to thank Tommy Robicheski, Athletic Department intern, class of 2014. Tommy is responsible for all the media that you see here today. Certainly, I want to thank our IT staff and Chartwells for their great work. Donnie Netto, class of 1985, and SMU Sports Information Director, the best in the country. He's the one that arms me with all the information that you hear today. I also want to thank Bill Moore for his work leading up to this event and the great work that we know is going to happen tomorrow at the golf outing. Thank you, Bill. And certainly, last but not least, is Carolyn Todd Bray, class of 1997. She's assistant volleyball coach and the assistant M Club director. She's responsible for organizing this entire evening and has done an outstanding job. Thank you, Carolyn. I ask our scholar athletes, outstanding athletes, our new Hall of Fame members to join us near the stage immediately following the ceremony. We want to get some pictures taken care of and give you some photo opportunities as well. This concludes our 11th Annual Cardinal M Club Awards Ceremony. Thank you, and go Cardinals.
Hey, that was great.
Good job.
That was good.